Aloha everybody, welcome back. Here we are continuing our series on advanced custom fields with the Divi Theme Builder. Today we're gonna be going over the image field. So if you're just getting started using advanced custom fields with Divi, check out my other videos, then my text video to help you get started. If you do find this video helpful and appreciate the work that I did, hit that like button, subscribe, and let's get started. Okay, so here we are on our demo website that has nothing but advanced custom fields and Divi installed. We're at a post here. And what we want is we want the author to be able to put an image in here. Let's say for the product. We have our advanced custom fields and we have a field group that we created called product. And we want to go ahead and add a field. And of course we want the image field. Let's just go ahead and select that. All right, so we're gonna give it a name. We're gonna call this product image. And then when you're in the field, you could just press tab to auto-populate the field name. And we're gonna go ahead and give some instructions for our author. We are not going to make this required. Once again, if you're using advanced custom fields and you make these fields required and the author does not fill them out or does not input anything into those fields, you won't be able to publish the post. So we are not going to make this required. You see here we have three different types of formats in which we could return. So advanced custom fields can either return an array of data, which will include things like your alt tags and your title tags. It could return just the image URL, or it could return the image ID. Every image that you upload to WordPress is given an image ID. Same thing with every post that you create, every page that you create is given a post ID by WordPress, and that's what this will be pulling in, and we'll be showing you that in just a second here. You could also pull in the image URL, which is where the image lives on your website, and that will pull in this data. And like I said, this will pull in an array of data. For now, let's just go ahead and keep it on image ID. The preview size, we're gonna make this thumbnail 150 by 150. Now this preview size is just for the back end, such as where we are now. When the author is creating this page or product, this is what they're gonna see. They're gonna see a 150 by 150 thumbnail of the image that they wanna put on the page. This does not mean that the image is gonna show up on the page as 150 by 150. Okay, that we have to do on the front end when we're designing the page where this post is going to go. Okay, so the library option here is you could either allow them to upload an image and have access to the media library that's already on the website, or you can make it so that they have to upload a post. So we're gonna keep this at all. Here is where you could select any kind of restrictions to the image size and the file size. And you could even allow restrictions for file types. So if you want to leave out a particular file type, then what you need to do is list all the file types that you want to be allowed and then leave out any ones that you don't. We are not going to have any conditional logic or any wrapper attributes. And we are going to go ahead and close this field here. If you remember in our previous videos, all these settings we have are just standard settings and none of these settings have changed when we created our field group called product. Okay, so we have our field group and we have our field image and we're gonna go ahead and update this. And the most important thing is that this field group will show up on the post type that is equal to post. If you don't already know, you could have these field types show up almost anywhere on your website in templates and template parts. We are having this show up on every single post that is created. And then if you come over here to our post, you'll see I have an example post and we're gonna go ahead and edit this one. And when we come down here, you'll see we have our field group that we called product. And here's our product image field. Here's the instructions that we gave it, upload a product image. And let's go ahead and add an image. Now you'll see I have an image here that's already uploaded, or I could upload a file, just like any other kind of WordPress post. And you'll see over here, it's filled out already with the alt text, the title text, and a caption. And down here, you'll see the file URL, okay? So let's go ahead and select this one. So here's where you could see that every post is given an ID. If you look down on the bottom left corner of the screen, you will see that this little address toolbar says post equals 46. And that means that this post is given an ID of 46. So let's go ahead and update our post. And now we need to get this image into our post template. So here we are at our Divi Theme Builder, and you'll see that we have a custom template that is equal to all posts, which means that this custom body here that I'm editing will show up on all posts that are created. All right, so let's open it up. So here you'll see we have our post title and our post content. And we come down here and there's this little box that we created to input our data. We're just gonna go ahead and add underneath here. And when Divi gets funny like this and it wants to make it hard to add a box after this, one thing you could do is just come over here and go to the wireframe and get in there and create something new after it, like this one here. And that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add something after this H4. And after H4, we're gonna do an image. So now, since this is a template builder, we're not gonna just add an image, because if you add an image here, it's gonna show up on every single post. So what we need to do is come into our dynamic content selector and open this guy up. And you'll see that we have some Divi items that we could choose from. We have some other items that it has picked up, being that I use advanced custom fields and created other demos. And then down here, you'll see that it has our field group product and our one and only field in there, image. If you had other fields in this field group, they will show up here. For simplicity, I've erased them all and we just have this one. So let's go ahead and select product image and press OK. Let's go ahead and go back to our full view here and you'll see that it's down here. Now, of course, this is just a template, so it has no image to show. It's just gonna show an image icon, but it's pulling in the data is what it's gonna wanna do. Let's go ahead and save this. Come back to our post here and refresh it, and you'll see that it's pulled in our bike. One thing I do want to mention, if you created a new field group and or new fields, and you come to your theme builder and those fields are not available for you to choose from, such as right here, let's say your field group is not showing up, just back out of your theme builder, refresh it and re-enter that section and your new field groups will show up, okay? Okay, so our images here. So a couple things we'll notice is that it's way too big for our use, and it is also not pulling in any info such as a title tag. When I hover over this image, it should have a title tag. If you are using this just to pull in a logo or something decorative on your website, you don't need to always have alt tags and title tags. But if you're gonna use images that show something like this or are gonna show something to your reader, you definitely want to have all your title tags and your alt tags in there. Let's just go ahead and click in and inspect this element. And you'll see that it has the place for the alt tag and the title tag, but there is nothing in there. We definitely want something in there for our various screen readers and SEO purposes. Okay, and the reason why it is not showing all that data is because in our field group, we had it selecting only the image ID. If we come back in here, you'll see these options. These are important because even though Advanced Custom Fields is collecting all the data within that image, it's only gonna spit out what we need it to spit out, okay? And currently it's only spitting out the image ID, and that's just not enough. And if it were to only spit out the image URL, that would not quite be enough either. So let's go ahead and go back over here and select the image array and update it, and come back to our post and refresh it. Let's go ahead and inspect the element, and you'll see it's still not adding those items there, okay? And so what we need to do is in this image field that we created in Divi, we could come in here and we could go to our advanced settings, and you'll see we have our attributes right here. And this is where you would usually maybe put your image title and your alt text here. And instead of typing it in, once again, you could come in here and choose your field group down here, okay? So that's what we're gonna do. And same thing for our title. We're gonna save it all and we're gonna update our template. Let's come back to our post and refresh it. And it's still there and it's still not pulling in all the data that we need. Let's just go inspect it again. And you'll see the alt tag is now populated with our image again. Same thing with our title tag. It's just pulling in the image location. And again, that's not what we want. The answer is to come over here and in our field group, create those text fields. So let's go ahead and add a field, and we're gonna call this product image title. And then we're gonna press tab to auto-populate our field. This field type will be a text. We are gonna give them some instructions. We're not gonna make this required though. We're not gonna change any of these other rules, and we are not gonna add any conditional logic at this point. And let's go ahead and add one more, and we're gonna call this product image alt. Again, we're gonna press tab to auto-populate our field name. It's gonna be a text field, and we're gonna get some instructions. And once again, same thing, not gonna make it required, and these values down here, we are just gonna leave. And if we close our fields here, you'll see in our field group, we have a product image title, and a product image alt. and we're gonna go ahead and update these. Let's come back to our post editor here and refresh it. And now our new text fields are added here as well. So we're gonna go ahead and give this product an image. Now this image title, you could have used as the title up here as well. So you can make it so that's the same thing. For now, we're just gonna pretend that we are titling this image here. Okay, and we're gonna call it really cool bike. And down here, we're just gonna put something fancy like some alt text. Okay, so we're gonna update this. And so now we come back to our Divi template builder and come back into our image. And now we could go in and give it a link so that when someone clicks on that image, you don't always want this, but sometimes you want it to link to a larger image, or sometimes you want it to link to the actual product. And this is what I was talking about before. You see, so we created our fields and my new fields are not showing up in here. So let's just go ahead and get out of this and save all our changes if we made them and close our section here. And just make sure we come over here and save it, and that refreshes our whole builder. And let's come over here and reopen it, roll back down to our image, and let's work on our image. So now if we come back to our link field over here, and we have our options of our new items that we created. Now this is the product image and we could just have it link to that and that will be just fine. Where we want to use our new fields is in advanced and attributes, and we could come over here and you'll see it's already has them in here, and we could go ahead and get rid of these guys. And we're gonna go to our field group, select our image alt text, and then we could select our image title. Save all those guys. And if we come back and refresh, you'll see now that when I click it, it goes to the page and where it lives. And if I stay here, you'll see that it gives me my title tag. Really cool bike, there you go. Let's go ahead and inspect the element. And you'll see now our alt tag has our alt and our title tag has our title. So now we need to get this down to the size that we want. So let's go back to our theme builder over here. Let's come over here to our image and open it up. Let's go down to the design and do our sizing. And then you could come and make it something like, let's say 150 by 150. Save it. Come back and refresh and it's 150. And then you could have your description on to the right of it. You could obviously style this in different ways in which you want with your theme builder. This is just gonna show you how to start pulling that data into your theme builder to start using it. And last but not least, you might want to have a caption appear under your image. So you could just come over here. So you just come to your field group and add a new field. And instead of creating a new field, we could just come over here and duplicate it because we just want another text field. And we're gonna call this product image caption. Come in here and press tab. I'm gonna add a caption to it and keep all the settings the same. So let's go ahead and update this. Come back to our post here and refresh it. And we're gonna add a caption and we're gonna update it. And let's go ahead and put that under our image with a text block. So you can erase all this content that's auto-populated there and select your box here. And our caption, once again, is not gonna show up. Close this guy and refresh our template builder. Now go into your text box and add that content with our product image caption field. Go ahead and save this. And you'll see here is our caption that we could style and place anywhere around this image that we choose to. So this is a great opportunity to use conditional logic. This is a lot of information here to see on a post. And if the author never has not even uploaded an image, maybe these items don't need to show up as well. Let's go ahead and hide these until the author posts an image. So here we are back in our field group for the product. And we have our image and we're gonna leave this one just fine. So let's go ahead and close the image. And let's come into our product image title and edit it and scroll down. And now let's add some conditional logic. And we just basically wanna show this field if product image has any value, okay? You could set it to if it has no value, but obviously that doesn't make sense. And any value means that it has something inside it, okay? And let's go ahead and do that to the other ones as well and update it. Let's come back to our post here and refresh it so that those settings take effect. And obviously we have a bike here, so these things show up. Let's go ahead and delete this bike and you'll see automatically all those fields get taken away. And let's just go ahead and update this post real quick. Okay, our post has been updated and here's what it would look like if we came and we're creating a new post. Come down here and add an image. And when we go to add an image, you'll see our other fields are available. And these are only pre-populated because it's picking up the data from the back end of in our database. Otherwise, these would be blank. So that's a great opportunity of where you might want to use conditional logic. It's not very hard to use. And that's how you get started using the image field from advanced custom fields within Divi. So that would do it for this video. If you at all found it helpful, please hit that like button for me. Join me in my next video as we explore more advanced custom fields and Divi, and I'll see you in the next one. Aloha.